What is up, guys? Thaddeus here. You guys might recognize the background, sort of. I'm actually in Sebastian's apartment right now. I'm recording a YouTube video for my channel, obviously, and you know we're doing our own stuff. But basically, this video is actually gonna be super, super valuable for you guys who are actually, you know, just starting off, getting into the space, getting into the industry, and kind of like wanting to see results and figuring out how to get to that next step where, you know, I've talked to people who are like, hey, I've been drop shipping or having I've had a store for like 6-7 months, but I'm not getting sales. What do I do? How do I combat this? And my best response that I can give you guys, again, I'm trying to make this as valuable as possible for you, is the funnel. Okay, and breaking down this sort of funnel to reach your first $100 day. Because a lot of people haven't hit that mark yet. They haven't reached $100 days, right? I know I have an audience that, you know, some of my audience is doing really, really well, but most of my audience are beginners, are fresh to this space, and are looking to figure out how to get those first sales. Now, there's a few key ways to do this. I'm gonna show you guys the main way that I go about doing this, and basically, like, it works for me, so I don't stray from it, right? Obviously, you know, we wanna find something that works, and then when you replicate the process, you're just gonna keep doing what works, right? So that's what I'm gonna show you guys and walk through you guys right now, okay? So, first things first, the actual funnel. Like, how do we actually go about getting a complete stranger that we don't know, we've never met, to eventually put in their credit card information on our website and purchase a product, right? Whatever we're selling. Now, that's like, this is point A and that's point B, right? We wanna get them from complete stranger to person that just bought a product from us and now we have the money in our bank account, right? How do we do that? We gotta connect the dots somehow. But there's different little stages inside that we need to basically perfect to actually reach that point. Now, how do we actually get the stranger to even like notice us, right? There's a few things we wanna do. First of all, how are you actually going to attract this visitor, this customer? How are you actually gonna get them to notice you, right? You can either go, hey, I wanna do, you know, paid ads. I wanna hop on Facebook. I wanna hop on Instagram, sponsored posts, whatever it is. Now, what I like to do, right, and especially for my students in the program, I call it the bull rush technique. Now, I wouldn't do this just starting off, right? This is something that I want you guys to just keep in mind in the back of the head because it'll come up later, okay? This is called the bull rush strategy. What I do is, no, it doesn't have to do with anything with paid ads, with, you know, your cost per conversion, nothing in that paid ad sense, okay? We're talking about Instagram influencers, okay? Basically, what the bull rush strategy does is, again, it's called the bull rush because basically, for example, we find 10 or 20 influencers, right, that we already know work. This is the key point. You have to already know that they work and that they're legit and that you vetted them, okay? So we either have 10 or 20, right, that we're like, okay, we know these guys work. So now, in the course of a 48-hour time period, okay, in the course of a 48-hour time period is when we go from having zero people, you know, on our website, for instance, right, to now we have so much data we don't know what to do with. We can start retargeting, we can start lookalike audiences, we can go off, okay? Now, to connect those two points, it's called the bull rush strategy, okay? And what that does is, again, we have 20 Instagram influencers, for instance, right? You can have as many as you want, depending on your budget. This is usually a bit of a pricier take on marketing, but this builds up data very fast, and it'll bring me back to my point on the entire funnel later, okay? Now, with this actual strategy, we're going 20 influencers, and we're gonna split that up. So 50% of the actual following, okay? So not 50% of the influencers, okay? We're not cutting the influencers in half, but every influencer has a different amount of followers, okay? You're gonna add those all up and then cut that in half. And so you want 50% of the actual following, all those influencers that have those sort of like, that have that sort of following, they're gonna throw up shout outs first, okay? In this 48-hour time span, okay? 50% of the following, shout outs right away. All however many influencers you use, right away. Then you use the rest in sort of like a trickling effect for that next 24, whatever hour, 36 hour time period, okay? Following those original big influencers, right? So if you think about it, we had 50% of, for example, if we had 20 influencers with 20 million followers, right? All combined, right? 10 million followers, we'd use shout outs for that first half, right? Right when the bull rush starts, okay? Then for the next 36 hours, we're having that trickling effect of those other 10 million followers, right? However many influencers that actually is, that trickles, okay? Now why I call that the bull rush strategy is because you're getting so much data, you're hitting the market with so much force that one, okay? People are gonna see this everywhere, okay? And then two, it plays as a little bit of a psychology trick, because most of the time, especially if you understand who your customer profile is, you'll actually, like, they'll be following multiple of those pages that you're using, okay? Especially if you're doing a really, really big bull rush attack, okay? What I mean by that is, oh, they'll see, like, they'll be scrolling through Instagram, they'll see a post of your product, they'll be like, oh, that's interesting, right? Again, depending on your content, how you brand it, whatever, you could get them there. But oftentimes, guys, again, if you're familiar with Facebook, you know that oftentimes, some people have to see the same ad multiple times, okay? You need multiple impressions on someone to actually get them to eventually click through and convert, all right? Same with Instagram sometimes, okay? So now, why this is so effective is because, again, we hit the market hard with that 50%, that 10 million people, right, for instance, okay? A bunch of people saw you're getting traffic to your site, you're getting sales, but then you have this trickle effect where now anyone that was interested but was considering, they're seeing it on other pages. So now they're scrolling through, they're like, oh, I saw this earlier, wait, they're on this page too, and they scroll over, they might even see it on third one, like, oh, let's see it on this page too, like, I'm gonna check it out. And most of the time, guys, that's how literally you can make 45K in a day, 30K in a day, just because of that method, okay? But the primary method of that, because again, if you're gonna make 30K, 45K in a day, you're probably gonna spend around $6,000 to $8,000 in shoutouts, okay? Because again, you gotta know the influencers work, all right? And you gotta do a lot. That's how you make this strategy very, very effective. It's a little bit of a pricier investment, but it pays off a lot, especially if it's done well. Now, going back to the big funnel, right, that we're talking about, because right, a lot of my beginners probably aren't going to spend, you know, $6,000 to $8,000 on a bullish strategy right off the bat. I would not ever advise that either. So, going back to the big funnel of complete visitor to website, right? How do we do this on a much smaller scale, okay, to get your first $100 a day, to actually build up and start doing $100 days, right? Obviously, the price point of your product is going to play a role. Make sure you're not undercharging, okay? You don't want to be undercharging for your products. I know a lot of people, like, if you're selling bracelets, for instance, right? Bead bracelets. I sold a bunch of these, okay? If you're selling bead bracelets, I was selling them for $18. They were costing me $2 plus another $2 for e-packet, $4.50 max, okay? I'm selling for $18. And people selling them for like $8 or $7, and you're just shooting yourself in the foot, guys, okay? You got to make sure that you can actually price your products effectively, but you also have to make sure that your content, your branding, all that kind of stuff plays a role and that it can justify a higher price point, okay? Now, how do you actually do this? Again, this is the funnel. All these small things I'm telling you guys right now, you have to pay attention to and implement. If just one of these things is off, you won't get sales. For instance, if you're trying to sell a $20 bracelet that costs $2, but your content is whack and your branding sucks, you won't be able to get sales, guys. And that's why a lot of people are like, oh, I can't get sales, and they're charging this much, but their content's super bad, they're still using stock images, all this kind of stuff. And then they're complaining and saying, like, it's not working out for me. Well, yeah, because you didn't go the extra mile and do custom content, and you had everything else in place, but this one step messed everything else up, okay? So again, guys, I know I'm kind of going, you know, like here, but I'm trying to, like, slowly piece together this broad funnel for you guys, so you guys can kind of get an understanding. But I'm going back to, again, complete visitor, someone purchasing your product, right? Now we have the bull rush strategy, right, which takes them from here to here. Again, you need to have everything set up, your content, your Instagram profile, custom content, your social media profiles, like for Instagram, for example, need to be built, okay? You can't have just 5 followers. Oftentimes, for a store that's brand new, I encourage people, again, everything has to be good, though, to actually buy followers, right, to get to that 10K mark. But again, you need a lot of posts on your profile already. The posts have to be good, right? Custom content, again, right? See where I'm going with this? Everything plays a role in this, okay? But if you do it right, you can get a lot of money, revenue, right? So again, everything has to be set up. So again, if we're doing the bullish strategy, whatever we're doing with that, right, to actually attract these visitors to our store, you have to have the funnel. Now, if we're talking complete newbie, if you have no, you know, maybe you have like $500 max for a budget, right, here's what I would do. I would experiment with smaller themed pages on Instagram, right? Because again, if you have no idea how to use Facebook ads, you're probably going to lose that $500 just because you don't know how to, like you need to be able to experiment with Facebook ads to see good returns. Because what I found interesting, especially recently, because I'm filming a 0-1K challenge just for you guys, we've already passed 1K actually, but might call it a 10K challenge at this point, but because of what I'm doing, guys, experimentation is key. Like, I've actually found with higher budgets, higher daily budgets, they can convert more than just a $10 a day budget, right, for a product, right? And that's what I'm saying with Facebook, you just have to constantly experiment. So if you don't have a lot of money, then I wouldn't necessarily advise to go to Facebook first and bring in cold traffic. What I would do is go to a theme page, right? Because again, you can get shoutouts dirt cheap these days, especially after you vet a page, so $5 or $10, right? To bring in that initial traction and start building up your Facebook data so that eventually, right, when you have orders, like for example, say you have 50 orders, 100 orders, right? You take that, you export those orders, you upload that list to Facebook, you build off a lookalike audience of those orders, and then you start running, you know, conversion ads for those, for website conversions, okay? Like there's a lot of things you can do here. And like, I know I'm kind of going all over the place, but I know you guys will understand like these different points and being able to like use them, guys. I'm literally like, I'm on 2 hours of sleep right now, but I'm trying to like divulge to you guys all this stuff that you guys can use to literally get converted. I'm literally giving you guys so much value right now. But going back to that, right? If you have a $500 or less budget, don't go straight to Facebook ads. I would test some influencer pages first. Again, if I was going to Facebook ads, running cold traffic, it would probably be like view content ads, okay? But then view content ads is its own separate funnel in itself, okay? Because you have view content here, which is cold traffic. You gotta narrow it down, okay? So it's view content, then, okay, people who engage with my posts, all right? Then the people who engage with my posts, I'm gonna run website conversion ads or add to cart ads. And then the people that abandon those, I'm gonna add, you know, website conversion ads to people that abandon the cart, okay? So there's funnels to everything, guys. And so like in this giant funnel from stranger to money in your bank account, every single step here across this funnel has a funnel in itself, okay? And that's what you really, really need to understand to be good in dropshipping, to be good in really any industry, is to understand that there's funnels to every single thing you do, okay? And I'm trying to break that down here for you guys to actually show you guys how you can go from, you know, zero sales to over $100 a day every single day, as long as you put the systems in place to actually be able to do that. Because you're shooting yourself in the foot by not setting everything up first and then trying to do, you know, one or two things and then having everything just not work and fall to pieces because you didn't set everything up properly, right? Okay, now, next thing we wanna talk about is, for example, so again, if you have more than $500, you can do that whole view content strategy funnel, right, for running cold traffic and then, you know, target with retargeting ads later on. Or you can, you know, run really cheap shoutouts, you know, $5, $10, $15, $20, $30 shoutouts, okay, on these big Instagram themed pages to actually start generating that cold traffic. Okay, because again, with theme pages, people follow theme pages for a reason. They're interested in that theme, right? They're interested in men's fashion, women's fashion, anything even more specific, okay? So you already know that those followers are interested. Now, as long as you vet that they're real, then you're good to go, okay? Then you're gonna spend a little bit of money, tweak, get that data, and all that time, you're still building that Facebook pixel data so you can do retargeting ads later. You can build lookalike audiences later. You can build lookalike audiences based on, you know, how many people engage with the post, the percent of people that, you know, watch a certain ad video, okay? There's so much you can do after you have that initial data, which I think is the hardest part for you guys that are trying to start off, is getting that initial data. That's the hardest part because you don't know where to start and you have so many different pieces of your funnel that you're like, what the hell do I do? And so again, I'm trying to break this down for you guys so you can kind of see the bigger picture and then see the smaller funnels inside this bigger funnel and then sort of see where you need to go or what you need to work on to actually make that happen, okay? I had a lot of caffeine because again, 2 hours of sleep. Now, so let's say for example, like the overall funnel, right, is you need a visitor from somewhere, paid ads, Instagram shoutouts, whatever it is, okay, to either one, see your social media profile, your Instagram profile, that has to be good, okay? If you're driving them straight to your website, the website has to be good enough where two, it can captivate people, it can make sure that they trust your brand, make them feel some sort of emotion, because again, people buy on emotion, not logic. They buy with emotion, then they rationalize it with logic, okay? So you need to understand that and get in your customer's head to make that happen, okay? Now, whatever your traffic source is, right, and wherever you're sending them to, whether it's your Instagram profile, okay, your social media profile or your website, both of those jobs have to be able to convince someone to further pursue or get more curious about your product, your business, your brand, whatever that is, so that eventually, boom, now they're looking at the product, right? Now they're actually viewing the content of your store, your product page, and your product's page job is supposed to, again, close them on the sale. This is all a funnel. See how many funnels we have, guys? Like funnels, those are big words here, okay? We have funnels. Now, the product page funnel, again, is supposed to get them to close so they proceed to checkout and then purchase, okay? So there's a lot of these different funnels that come into place. I know it's a longer video, but I wanted to sort of break this down for you guys so you can understand sort of what you need to do to get to this $100 a day mark. Because again, whatever you're selling, for example, if you're selling a $20 bracelet, to reach $100 a day in revenue, That's what, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, five orders a day. Five people in this world of 7 billion plus need to buy a bracelet from you. Okay, when you put things in a bigger perspective, you can kind of understand what you need to work on and where you kind of need to go. Okay, so $100 a day, guys, is a really pretty easy milestone once you have these funnels in place, once you have the systems in place, so that boom, you have a traffic source generator. Now you have something that'll convert that traffic source, and it'll either, like, so again, how you want to think about it is, especially with these funnels, is you want to de-qualify people as fast as possible. Okay, so the funnel's supposed to narrow people down, right? And so it kind of like throw people out that aren't really interested, and then keep the ones that really, really are, so that you can get those ones to convert, okay? That's like a funnel's job in an instance, right? Now, a lot of people, they don't think about it that way. They think about funnels where it's like, okay, I have to make it so good, and that, you know, I need a bunch of people up here so that at least, you know, one or two come out down here that will buy my stuff. And that's not the way to think about it. The way to think about it is to be like, okay, I want to get rid of as many people that are never going to touch my stuff as possible, so that I can actually focus on having more people that just, you know, trickle down and buy my product. Like, you need to de-qualify people from your funnels as fast as possible, okay? Preferably up here on the funnel rather than down here on the funnel, all right? That's why content is so valuable up here, okay? Because if you do this well, you can captivate more people, and you can actually de-qualify more people because of your content, because of your branding, and because you have more access to public facing material, which is custom content, okay guys? I know this was a bit of a longer video, and I know, you know, I jumped around a little bit, but again, this is the bigger funnel. Okay, I want to reiterate this. I know I said a lot, but this is a bigger funnel, okay? From complete stranger all the way to money in your bank account. Now, you got to figure out how to do that. And there's different funnels that I've talked about in this video that can help get you there and help put the systems in place to be able to make that happen, okay, guys? Now, if you guys do have questions or whatever it is, feel free to hop in our Facebook group, Ecom Challenges. You know, if you have questions, you can also leave them down in the comments below. I respond to everybody's comments. Don't forget to leave a like, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you guys enjoy Sebastian's backdrop. Shout out to Sebastian, the homie. Yeah, guys, if you have questions or if you wanna hop in the course, you can check out the welcome page down below for more information, just to see if it's right for you. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care, peace. I will see you guys, again, I'm very tired. I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care, peace. I'll probably do a screen share walkthrough too of certain funnels, guys. So again, depending on what funnels you guys have questions of, drop a comment below, because I really want to actually help you guys kind of walk through each specific one, and get you guys, you know, what you need to help get those sales rolling through. Okay, guys, but that's the general overview. So I hope you guys enjoy. I'll see you guys next video. Take care. Peace.